I love Star Trek, which is why I hate bad Star Trek. If you've watched very much Star Trek, you know exactly what I mean. Bad acting, boring stories, ham-fisted social commentary.
We the people.
You know exactly what bad Star Trek is. But how do you tell good Star Trek from bad Star Trek? Well, mostly you just gotta sit through it. Unless you got me with you. I'll sit through the bad stuff for you. So without any further delay, this is POS TOS, The Enterprise Incident. Now, surprisingly, the Enterprise incident is actually one of the most popular episodes of the series. Fans, they cut a lot of slack because it features the Romulans, one of the most popular parts of Star Trek. But when you really stop and look at the episode, it's not the worst there is, but it's not the best either. The episode begins with Captain Kirk off his rocker. Well, more so. So, with no explanation why, Kirk orders the Enterprise into Romulan space. Almost immediately, they are beset by Klingons?
Klingons!
Intelligence reports Romulans now using Klingon design.
No, you can't just switch that around. You have Romulan ships. Why? Oh, look. Here come the Klingons now. Uh-oh, Ferengi are coming too. Oh good, the Vulcans have arrived to help us. See, I can do that too. How far are we into this? So the Enterprise is now surrounded in two dimensions. After we waste time negotiating for a bit.
No one should decide quickly to die, Captain. We give you one of your hours.
Well, 50 minutes actually, but after commercials, it'll round out to about an hour. Kirk and Spock beam over to the Romulan ship. There they are accosted by the Commander. Kirk, being the amoral sociopath that he is, blames an instrument failure. The Romulan Commander doesn't buy his story, and so we are at an impasse. That is until Spock speaks up and puts the blame solely on Kirk. For some reason, Kirk is upset by this, but it makes no difference as he's carted off to the brig. The Romulan commander, however, seems to have a very different intention with Spock than with Kirk. The two engage in some rampant Romulan fan service for a while, and then we return to visit with Captain Kirk, beating his head against the force field. This, of course, puts him out of commission, and so Dr. McCoy is brought aboard the Romulan vessel.
Now say nuclear vessels.
No.
Dr. McCoy then unintentionally confirms Spock's claim that Kirk is a raving, babbling sociopath. Kirk then manages to testify the exact same thing in his own unique Shatnerian way.
Bum ba da bum 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 ba 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 bum.
I am insane.
Spock, what are you doing, Spock?
I instinctively used the Vulcan death grip.
The Vulcan death grip. Let's look at that again and see just how quickly and instinctive this all was. Oh, ah yes, clearly, in the wink of an eye. And so Kirk is dead. Okay. Meanwhile, back on the Enterprise, Nurse Chapel finds herself needing some exposition.
Jim and Spock were operating on Federation orders.
My neck feels like it's been twisted off.
That's the Vulcan death grip for you.
There's no such thing as a Vulcan death grip.
Oh, but the Romulans don't know that. Sure fooled the doctors.
That's what this whole masquerade was about. To keep the Enterprise and the Federation off the hook.
So that if anything went wrong, you would be the one to blame.
That's right. Our noble Federation ordering one of their captains to be the patsy for them so that they can spy on their enemies and steal their technology.
Bones, I want you to prepare for surgery.
But they don't approve of waterboarding. So apparently the plan is to send a Federation operative on board the Romulan ship in order to steal the cloaking device. Okay, it makes sense. The Federation has had to make tough choices in the name of security before, so who are they going to send? I know, maybe this will be the chance for Sulu or Chekov or even Uhura to get a chance to go on board and... What? Oh. Think this through. The Romulans have now met three Federation officers from the Enterprise. Kirk, Spock, and McCoy. So who do they send? Kirk. Let's send one of the 3 out of 430 some odd people that they've met. What could go wrong? Oh, set course for wackiness. But first, Captain Kirk has some logistical problems to deal with.
I'll need a Romulan uniform.
So, who do we turn to but Scotty?
It'll be a pleasure.
No. No! No! Why is it such a pleasure to him?
People say that...
Mr. Scott, what do you have to say for yourself after defiling that Romulan?
That's green. That's green.
So as hijinks are ensuing in the engine room, Spock, as the new captain, then begins to...
It doesn't seem to me that's enough.
I don't know what he... Are they? Perhaps there's something about the role of the captain of the Enterprise that does something to a man, because as soon as Spock accepts command of the Enterprise, his method of negotiation suddenly mirrors that of Captain Kirk himself.
You will lead a small party of Romulans aboard the Enterprise. And there you will take your rightful place as its commander. And you will lead the ship to a Romulan port with my flagship at its side.
But not just this moment. An hour from now will do. Even better.
But Spock's duplicity is found out because, amazingly, the Romulans have the ability to track transmissions inside their own ships. Meanwhile, at Pier 1, Kirk, who is barely trained in any sort of engineering detail whatsoever, manages to extricate this foreign and high-tech, super-secret technology in about as long as it takes Spock to make time with the Romulan commander. I guess it helps when it's not hooked up to any sort of power source or anything. My GameCube has more wires hooked up to it than that thing. So Kirk, the noble captain that he is, leaves his first officer behind and beams right on out of there.
The right is granted.
Spock, meanwhile, uses his knowledge of Romulan law to delay his own execution.
I shall not require much time. No more than 20 minutes, I should say.
In the middle of the earth, in the land of Shire, there's a brave little hobbit whom we all admire. With his long wooden pipe, fuzzy woolly toes, he lives in a hobbit hole and everybody knows him, Bilbo.
Transporter room. Steam, Mr. Spock aboard.
And so Spock is saved too, and he's even brought a friend with him.
The Romulan commander.
So the Enterprise escapes by moving in three dimensions. The Romulans hot in pursuit. Scotty now has his own mini-game to play, installing a fully functional Romulan cloaking device that he's never seen before.
It's a lot easier taking things apart than putting them back together.
Come on, Mr. Scott, I took it apart in 5 seconds. You can't do better than that? But of course, we don't have any more time in the episode for a new story twist, so it works. And the Enterprise cloaks and gets away. So, our noble heroes have lied, cheated, stolen, and kidnapped, and now they're on their way back home with no consequences. We risk interstellar war.
Captain, please go. Somehow, they do not look aesthetically agreeable on humans.
Yeah, I suppose for a Vulcan, it's kind of like doing blackface. So there you have it, the Enterprise incident. Is it one of the worst? No. But it's not as good as what people would have you think. is full of inconsistencies and illogic, and what's more, it's just not what our heroes should be doing. They're supposed to be heroes. Yes, sometimes heroes need to do a bad thing, but there doesn't seem to be any sort of soul searching done. Well, they're aliens, they have technology we want, let's get it! So decide for yourself whether it's a good episode or not. As for me, I'm calling it POS TOS.
It's just not enough. Oh, man. My darling, I can't get enough of your love, babe. Girl, I don't know why I can't get enough of your love, babe. Lord, some things I can't get used to, no matter how I try. It's like the more you give, the more I want. And baby, that's no lie. Oh, no, babe. Tell me, what can I say? What am I gonna do? How should I feel with everything in you? What kind of love is this that you're giving me? Is it in your kiss or just because you're sweet? Girl, all I know is every time you're here, I feel the change. Something moves, I scream your name. Look what you got to do.
That's green.